an example to hundreds of thousands in the 60s for his political activism, Rennie Davis now talks of meditation and a breakthrough in human consciousness as solution to the world's problems. Though we may share his disillusionment with politics, we can be excused, perhaps, if we find his alternatives hard to accept. Operating manual for Spaceship Earth. Hear all about those do's and don'ts. Operating manual for Spaceship Earth. Find out about those do's and don'ts. The blood in our veins. Operating manual for Spaceship Earth. Hear all about those do's and don'ts. Operating manual for Spaceship Earth. Find out about those do's and don'ts. Do be kind to your animal friends. You are the keeper of the zoo. Do be kind to your vegetable friends. You are the gardener of that garden. Operating manual for Spaceship Earth. Hear all about those do's and don'ts. Operating manual for Spaceship Earth. Find out about those do's and don'ts. The serpent. In the Bible, of course, it was the embodiment of evil, of Satan. But in ancient Eastern scriptures, thousands of years before the Old Testament, the serpent was held in far greater esteem. Envisioned as lying coiled asleep at the base of the human spine, it was symbolic of the power of the universe, awaiting man's enlightened command. The individual who awakened his kundalini, or serpent fire, would begin the cosmic transformation of his human capabilities. Extraordinary powers and the wisdom of the universe would become his. Rennie Davis, then, and millions of others who share his optimism, foresee a fundamental alteration in human consciousness, brought about by our very need for it now in this time of crisis. This awakening of human potential is to be basically the same as that attained throughout the ages by a few gifted individuals, psychics, visionaries, mystics, and saints. The predicted difference is that this tremendous resource can now be greatly amplified through the global communications media. To some, the new spiritual influence from the East is a threatening intrusion. They are alarmed when their children renounce their way of life and follow teachings which seem so alien. Could they have been brainwashed?
One day when the scientist he said his loving energy may heal nervous to shine. One day when a man among the throng will see that he is wrong, his universe will shine. One day when immensity is near, this man will conquer fear, and universe will shine. One day when the serpent fire arrives that coiled within us lies, the universe will shine. There is a notion of vast proportion, and she flows within ourselves. To take dips daily, we dive in gaily. He knows who goes within himself.
how one meditates and what one experiences in this ancient technique of quieting the mind depend on the individual. Those who have practiced and studied it, however, from yogis thousands of years ago to scientists measuring its effect in the laboratory today, are convinced of its healthful benefits. As one learns to subdue the incessant drone and chatter of the mind, a glimmer of intuition begins to emerge. Visionaries have said that this faculty is as superior to rational thought as thinking is to the instinct of animals. Is it a message from another world, a teaching from a higher dimension of being, or a voice from a more subtle, perhaps divine part of our own selves?
It was up some laughing river where I'd gone to spend a day. I had such fantastic visions, I could hardly stand to stay. And I stood up within myself, and suddenly felt free. And I stood above the burning days that huzzah in my brain. I became awareness that was shared with all around. With the sky, the trees, the flowers, and the wind, the sun, the ground. I heard the birds were singing, and I found them same as me. And I understood our song of those, and why they should not be.
Yeah.